Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Yesterday we created a very, very cool Flask application where we used some forms. And today I would like to clean up the forms because actually they ended up looking like this, which is not that nice. They worked actually the forms and they did what they should, and they deserve their purpose, so to say. But today I would like to change it so it actually looks much nicer. We need the fields to be under the labels. We need a nice styled button, and in general we'd actually like to clean up the styling bit. So it's a lot about styling tonight. Let us just get started. First of all, the shopping cart button out here, we're not using it right now, so let us just remove it. It's just noise. The colors here, I don't like the colors, so let us change the colors. Then when we come into this area here, we need to remodel the most of this actually. So, but let us just get into it. First, I'll start with removing the shopping cart button because we actually don't need it right now. We can always add it again later on. So let me go to my main template, which is right here. So I will go and find the shopping cart, which is right here. We'll just outcomment it. We could also, of course, it's a little bit ugly that we still have it. But also first let's do our comments and let's see how it looks. We'll take a small step at a time, refresh the page. And now it's gone, but now all my menu, my navigation header is now pushed to the right instead. That's okay if we want that, then that's fine. And actually I would like to have it like that for now, at least. If I don't want it, then I can just leave the deal right here, because we have that space around. We're using flex up here in the top, so but let me just see here. If you want in the middle, then I can just leave in the empty div right there. So but yeah, okay, we can just keep it like this, that's fine. The next thing is actually the colors in the header. Let us just go look at that a bit. So I go to the navigation CSS. Another thing, I actually chose star, and then I chose background color black and color white. I think this is also a little bit wrong, I think, because I would like to control the background and the color a bit more gradually on each HTML tag. So I'll choose body instead, like this, and let us just see how it looks. So actually right now we actually have a new color for the header. That's probably because we have set the color somewhere. Go to our nav links A down here. We can actually see we have a background, but there's actually no color. So that's probably the color of the anchor when they have been clicked all once before. And if we want the color to be white again for the header like this, then we can just add it, and we can actually set the color to white, or we can also choose yellow if that's what we want to. So let us do that. So here we have yellow. It actually looks pretty good with yellow, but the background, I'm not happy with that. Let us just find the background, and if you're using IntelliJ, then you can see all the colors here. And if you click that color, you can actually choose another color. I like bluish colors actually, or maybe like purple colors, or maybe light blue, dark blue. Let's try something. Let's try some blue colors right here. We can always change it. We can also set something called variables. So let me just, it needs to be a bit dark, I think. Go refresh. So now we have a blue. We have a blue header, blue menu, navigation. We have a blue navigation header right here. Let us give the corners only get round when we actually hover above them. Let us try to give them some default round edges, and we do that with the next. You see down here we have the hover right here, then we have a border radius of 10. We could actually have a border radius of 5 for that. Then when we hover, then we actually. And now look, now they're nice and round, and then they just get a little bit more round when we hover on top of them. And if you don't want the space between them, then we can actually remove the space like this and remove the margin. So now they are stuck together. Then we probably, if we want that, then we probably need then we probably need to remove the rounding, so it doesn't look that weird. If we remove the border radius again, that looks a bit cooler. So now we actually have this action bar right here. You click all the links, of course, and this is the menu right now. It looks like this, and this is what we want to work on. And this is my picture from my first school day. So, but let's say that now the header is actually okay. The header says as we like it. We can play a bit more with it later. So let's target the form right here. The way we can do that is actually we can create a new. We should create a new style sheet called new spaceship .css. And let's just do that. New. Is it? I'll just choose a new file. Why can't I find it? Okay, that is style sheet, of course. I was looking for CSS, that's why. So, okay, new spaceship. But we don't need to give the last name. Add it to Git. Yes, thank you very much. Here we have it. So this is the new spaceship. And then, of course, I would like to have it down in my new spaceship template right here. I would actually like to add this. I would actually like to add this style sheet right here. But because we're using a parent template, then we need to go to the parent template. But it is not that nice that we need to add a lot of weird link declarations up here with the styles in it, which we will get a lot of styles, and maybe the style sheets will actually conflict. So what we will do actually is we will use the ginger block statement again up here. So that means we will actually create a new block. We already have a block for the title on the browser tab. We'll create a new block which is called extra header. Block extra header. That means that if some of the one of the sub templates actually, if they want to add some styles sheets, then they can actually do it by filling out this block right here. And that's exactly what we're going to do. I'm going to my new spaceship template, which is the same as when I press this tab, then we will actually get this template right here. And then we'll go down in the bottom, and then we'll actually add. Then I'll add a link statement like this, copy, go down at the bottom here. It doesn't matter why we have these block statements, because they're going to be placed in the right space in my main template's HTML file. Ginger will do that for us. So right now we have static, we have file name, and to change this to new spaceship.css like this. So that means that now we're actually importing this style sheet right here, right now there's no content in it actually at all. And right now this is actually the content right here. Here's my form. Let us delete that line, because of course we can see that that's a form and it's not that interesting. And then it's actually a good practice to contain all of this, all of your sub content in a div. So we'll start with doing that. So that's kind of like our master div or something or like that. But then from here, I would actually like to have a wrapper, so I'll choose, we can keep the header like that. So we have a header, then we'd like to start the form down here like this. We have a div right here, and the class here equals to form wrapper like this, and I'll go down in the bottom. After form, then we need to end with the div. I'll format it. I've chosen the keys Ctrl+F in the IntelliJ for this. Of course, you can choose shortcut keys, or you can click up in the menu and say format. I think it's on a code actually. Reformat code. But there, it's also Ctrl+L, which is not a good button, because that actually also locks the machine and opens the machines. So yeah. So this was the wrapper. Then I would actually like to create another div, which is actually called the form itself. Form spaceship. So that means that actually now I can control what happens out here, and then I can actually if I wanted to, then I could, if it wasn't already centered, then I could add a margin and margin outer and then center it so it goes to the middle. That's why I have this form wrapper actually. And then inside this spaceship, then we can actually target, and we can target our form, and then we can set it up with a flex grid layout, which I will choose now. But right now, if I go out and look here, refresh, this is how it looks now. Then we have the header right here, and then we have our then we have our input fields right here, and we have a label which matches the field. First of all, I would like the label to go on top of the input field, and I would like in the beginning we can actually try to have multiple columns. Let us just play around with that. If I go to a new spaceship like this, then I can actually choose my class like this, and then I can say go to form. Inside the form, let us choose display and then grid, and then I can flex template. Oh, hopefully a template grid template columns. That's what. Then I can say one fragment and one fragment. Let's just see how that looks just to begin with. Looks like this. Not very nice, but now we have two columns as we can see. Another thing is that actually the header, I would actually like content to be centered there. So text align. Line center. And let us just choose one column for now. Oops, please. I want to add another style, which is called item, which I called form item or something like that. It's a field item. And inside this field item, I would actually like to have a display flex. Means that that's a one dimensional way of actually saying that we want stuff placed in my case I wanted to place in one column. So we get the label and then we get the input field. So first we have the display and then we have the flex, and then I can actually choose which direction I want. The flex direction, this, let me choose column, and let me just go back. Field item, I need to apply this of course, so I go back. Okay, it's actually already named field. Okay, let us rename this. So I've already prepared this rename actually. So now it's called field item. Each of these items here. There's another thing I would like to do actually, and that is to move the arrow to the bottom of each field. It just makes more sense. So we created this arrow here yesterday. So if there's any errors any validation error on the field, then it will be shown in the top. I actually prefer to get it shown in the bottom like this. So let us just move them all. It makes a bit more sense. So first we can actually read the label and the data, and then after that we can see are there any errors. Just feels more the order just feels a bit more right. Like this. Back, see how it looks now. Now we have them nicely aligned. We have the label, we have the input field, we have the label, we have the input field. Let us, you can see here inside the label, we actually would like to have some spacing here. That's called margin. So we'd like to have some bottom margin to so it looks a bit better. And we can target that because we have the field item right here. That means if I want to target the label, then I say this is a class name, and then I say label, and that's because it is actually the HTML tag label, which will be generated by Flask. So then by the Flask forms, and then we have the label right here, and then I can actually say margin bottom this, and then we can give a margin like 1 rem. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, it's actually fine. And then field item, maybe actually it could both be the label, but it could also be the input field actually. Now we both have it on the input field and on the label itself. Actually, I would like to target the label by itself, because then we can actually also choose the font color and stuff. That's what we have the color. the color here, what kind of color should that be? If you don't know the color, then we can choose choose color, and then we can actually just pick it out in this wheel right here. So should it be, it should be a light color, right? Because the background is so dark. We can have kind of a greenish color. Choose, start with that. And you also have the font size. Have that to 0.8 rem. And actually the font right here, the font, it's not the correct font. It's this is the default font. We should apply the same font as we have in the header. And there are actually multiple ways of doing that, but let me just go see if I can find the font in my navigation CSS. Look here, we actually, we imported it right here. Actually, I think this is a global thing. I would like this font to be available all over. So let me just go to my styles. I'll import it there. Created by, we don't need that anymore. So, and let me just find in the navigation, we have the font settings somewhere. Font, let's just search for. Oh, that is font for Lobster 2 cursive. That's for the nav bar, it's 1.2 IM. So, but let's just go out here and then we say, okay, we also have the body style. Okay, let us choose the font right there. Let me cut this and put that in the main style file. I think it makes more sense to have it there. And let us just see what happens. So now we actually have the font all in the whole HTML page. It's a bit too small right here, and maybe we need to be careful that we don't introduce too many colors. So if we are using yellow up here, then we should also use yellow down here, I think. So let's do that. We can see here the button font, actually it did not change, so we need to set this font explicitly on the input fields. Let's say we set input, and then we say font family lobster. This. So now we also have, now we also will also get this font on all our input fields. You can see here that is the font. If it's pretty or not, I don't know. It was just one I chose to begin with, actually, when we started this tutorial many days ago. So let us for now just run with this font right here. We need to go to our style sheet right here. Then we need to set the margin bottom. We can actually set that on each of field items, actually. So this is, let's say we also put one in right here. Let's see what happens. Means now we get some spacing between each field. It could also be two, a little bit bigger. Nice, and then instead of having one, we can have 1.5 IEM right here. And the color, it's wrong, we could see that. And of course we should use variables, but let's do that another time. Right now, let us just play around. So now it's yellow. And the font is too small, so let us just say 0.2 IM. So then we have the labels right there. So now we can actually read the labels. That's a good thing, right? Actually, I would actually like to prefer these colors to be white, so the eyes catches actually the middle there. And that's, so let me just go to navigation. We go down and choose the that like this. Yeah, it looks better. Then we have the yellow stuff around here. That's okay because now we need to fill out this form right here. Let us see how big our deal actually is. So let us give this a background so we can see how big it is. And so if I go to a new spaceship, then we can actually give the form. This is the form wrapper. Then we go to the styles right here. Then we say form wrapper. Give it a background, and then the background that could be some color. choose the color. Thank you very much. I press control space there. And let me just get some bluish color. Or bluish. Let's take color right there. Choose. And let us also have a shadow. Have a box shadow. Auto shadow, sorry. It was box shadow, sorry, box shadow like this, and then we have like 4 pixels, and then we have some blur, 2 pixels blur, and we have the radius, let's do 2px, and then we need a set a color, and then the color should be a little bit darker than the color we just chose. Unfortunately, the IntelliJ remembers the colors right there, so I'll just put a darker gradient. This choose and let us just see how it looks. Ah, okay, it looks a little bit funny there. I can see that we need some padding also. Okay, that's because we need 2 dimensions here. 4 pixels, 4 pixels. There, so now the I think the be like. Also, was it in rems instead? 2 rem. So now the shadow actually it got too crazy. So let's choose 1 rem. A little bit too much. So 1.5 and. Okay, now it looks nice. We have a nice shade around it. But of course, the form right now doesn't look right, and that's because we need some padding. Padding 10 pixels. If you don't know how much padding to give, always start with 10 pixels. It's a good start. So, helped a bit. So take 20 maybe. 20 pixels. Ah, it looks better. So already now, it looks much, much better than it did before, right? So now we actually have a nice form. The button here, let us change the color of that. So that we could also change the background color, maybe on the white, it's a little bit, maybe it's fine that we have background, but actually I would like this to be, okay, let's start with the submit button, let's see how that looks first. So we have this field item right here, and we can actually go target. Actually, we could actually create this for all submit buttons, actually. I think I will actually make this general. So that means I will actually go up in top, I will say input, and then I will say that I want the type, type equals to submit. And let's check something out. I shouldn't use this one. Type equals submit, and I don't need to have this in brackets like that. So we have the so we have the type equals submit, and then I can actually set some styling for this. That means that then we'll have folders or submit buttons, then we'll have the same background color, for instance. So let me choose a background color. The background color, what should that be? Be a could be a dark color, be something like this. Be something like this, right? You say choose, yes, and then the color on the submit button, let us choose white. It gives a really good it gives a good, really good feeling when you have a dark background and a light color on top of that. Looks cool, I think. Focus, oh, not focus, hover. So let's say when we hover on top of it, then we give it a bit, then give it a lighter color actually. That means it will just that also be a bit more, be even lighter. that we can read it, so let us actually also be like an image color. Fun. And then we could set some animation on a transition. This transition, 0.3 seconds. If you don't know the timing, always choose 0.3 seconds and then 0 seconds. This is the delay. Then ease out is always a good F. Ease out way back. So let's just see how it looks. Fresh. I don't like the border here. I think the border is a bit. It's pretty good, but I don't like the border. And there's also something else I don't like. I would like to add some padding to all the input fields, both the ones we type and the ones that we click. So let's use some padding right here. I think these 20 pixels. Let's try that. And border none. And the input type submit. Border none still. It looks quite nice. The 20 pixel was too much. Padding, so. Actually looks pretty. It looks pretty really good. It looks really good. I think we can add some shades actually, so we can add some border box shade. Sorry, box shadow. Box shadow, and then we can take two pixels, some blur. Yeah, a little bit of blur. And the radius and 0 pixels, and then we give it a color. Use color. And of course we need to have that color, and then a little bit darker. Always nice hope. This use fresh. So now we have a little bit of shade. And but actually sometimes it's actually a good idea to remove the shade when on a hover up, that gives a really cool effect of the whole thing to move. None. I'll just write none. Fresh. Yeah. I actually don't want that. It looked better before. So you can also make let's check that out. Let me just check back here on this and I'll delete the slide. So this is our spaceship. Very, very cool. Let's try to make a mistake and see how it actually looks, because we also have some error handling, of course. There's also another thing. Yeah, okay, that's actually a good thing. And now when we type stuff, then we get an autocomplete, because we get some examples of what we could type. And it's really, really annoying, especially when we want to type in numbers and we want to type in some text, which is probably not something that we have chosen before. So we can actually disable this, and we did not see that yesterday, but there's actually, in our form, let me go to the form, special form right there, we can actually add something called render key values like this, and then we can actually add all the usual stuff that we usually we can add all the attributes that we usually give to our input fields manually in HTML. We can actually add that right here as a dictionary. So let us just add key value here. I can start with a placeholder. Placeholder. That means that when we haven't typed anything, what should have been in there? Then we can say something like, right, name, spaceship, and then we can have a. So remember that, and then we can have the autocorrect false. Let me just check if I remember correctly regarding the autocorrect. So page that was active. Did I close up? It was good. The values right there. Placeholder. Placeholder. Autocorrect. Name of spaceship. It actually looks okay. Let's just refresh. And just see what it says. What does it say? Value error, dictionary error, update, sequence element, length. Okay. So let us just go back maybe. Let us just start with one. We should not have it in other string, so we should not have it bracket. So, and this is a force like this. Let us try with this. Let's try to see if disappeared. Yeah, now it disappeared. Now it's a dictionary. I made it a string because I put quotes around all of it. So right now we actually got a placeholder right here. Name of the spaceship it says with a small gray color right there. And if I press and start typing stuff, we still get this. The autocorrect, there's an error there. So I'll just disable autocorrect. I forgot the right syntax. Autocomplete. Oh, okay, it's autocomplete instead. It should also be autocorrect. And then, okay, it's autocomplete, autocorrect, correct, or something called, and then we need to set all those off. Closer add, remove spell check, if that's what we want to. But the autocorrect, that's actually the one I wanted to choose. And then I actually need to set this off, because it's interpreted by the browser. So let's see here. Yeah. Look, now there's no autocorrect. Oh, yeah. Autocorrect, did I spell it correctly? Autocorrect, that should be okay. Totally okay. It should actually be, what did I say? Right, auto complete. Let us also try to write that auto complete. Off. Fresh. Now it's gone. Okay, it was auto complete. Sorry. There's auto correct and there's auto complete. So, but we have turned both of them off. And we right down here, we actually have, look here, we actually have the complete on there still, so we need to go and remove that. But that was really, really good. So let me copy this, and I'll add this to. I'll add this here. Come on. And then we'll choose for, that is for the crew. Number of crew members to handle the ship. Yeah, it should not be too long. Number of crew members. That's fine. So, also write something with like recommended. Recommended number of crew members. And let us add it also to. So it does not like this right here. We have our validators, they're right here. So we have the render key values right there, and then we have a comma right there. And I've accidentally finished it right there. That's an error. Let me go here and I'll add to the weight. I will need to add the same stuff right here. So we go add the or render keywords. So comma and then format, auto format. And then here we have the weight of the spaceship, yeah. Weight. Spaceship. Like this. And then go back and let us try to see. So now we have, look here, we have the placeholders. We have those gray text right there. Recommend, okay, it's a bit too long, the recommended value. The placeholder for recommended number of crew members. So we'll just make it shorter to number of crew members like this. Here, let me just try to press ES. And please fill out this form, all of them are required. Let's choose one, wait one, let's see what happens. I'll get the errors, and the errors here, it doesn't look that good, right? So let us style the errors a little bit. So we'll go to our new spaceship, and then we have the show error right here. And where did I place the show error? I think I placed it up in the main, actually. Yeah, that's removed. We're going to move this. Oh, yeah, this is just for our new spaceship. That's just to show the errors right here. Red, the font size, it should not be that big. One is, we don't need our own errors blown up like that. And the color, it's not that, like it's a little bit more subtle. Let's check an orange color. And margins and all that, we don't need the margins, I think. Need some padding maybe. You can also set a background, actually, that would give a cool effect. Background could be almost the same color as the other blue that we chose. Blue right there. Actually, we could choose that, like, have a dark background, actually. So we're going to choose this, and we're going to have a dark background, some padding, and then we can have a light foreground. Let's just see how it looks. Push, yes. It actually looks, it doesn't look that bad, does it? It does not look that bad. Field must. It's just difficult to read because it's because of the font also. So let us make it a bit fatter. Font weight. And we choose folder. Let's see what happens now. It starts to look like something, right? It must be between 5 and 25 characters. It's a bit like the form is a bit too big for the whole thing right now, so let us try to. I think we could actually set the form size a little bit smaller. And because we're using IM, that might actually have been a mistake. Then that's because that's from the root IM, so that means then we actually need to change all the. We actually need to change all the font sizes then. But. H1 here, we could set the font size to 0.8 on IM. What happens? Great spaceship, a little bit too small. Maybe 2%. A little bit smaller, and then we should try to remove the gap between all of the components of the fields right here. So let's just go to here already. So let's try to look at the padding and the margins. Have some margins on here. Margin button. The label, I think the label is okay. But the bottom right there, too much. Let's take one. That can almost be on page. Could be a little bit smaller, but it's 0.8. Now it's actually possible to have it on one page. This is really, really cool. Very, very good. Let's fix the first name first of here. We can call this, what should we call this? Swan. But that's not 5 characters. We need at least 5 characters. Swans. And then. Let's just try to create a hope. Now that the error disappeared from the name of the spaceship, but we still have number of crew members required, need to be between 10 and 1,000. Let's choose 100. choose the other name, let's say a round chip like this, that's fine. Wait again, now this one also disappeared. Made on Earth, number must be between 100 and 20,000, let us say 2 kilos. Or maybe it's probably tons, so 2,000 tons. Created, and now we have the round chip right here. Another thing, we cannot see, it's difficult to see which input field that has the focus, so we'll just go fix that actually. So let me just go check. We could do that in the master style sheet actually. If that's what we want, so then it will apply to all the input fields. So that means that here, instead of type submit, then we could actually choose type text. Or we could also just remove the type and then say, this is how, we could also choose, let's just start with text. So we can always remove them. And then we'd have a text with hover. Text hover. So to select the hover right here. So, and then we can say the background, we do not want to change that. We have some, that is fine. The color white is also, let us remove the, and maybe we want the background actually. Let's try to play around with the background also. Maybe that's actually the one we want. Then it has the same color as the submit button. That could actually be okay. Border none. Then we want a border bottom instead. And that could be 2 pixels. And it could be solid. And it could be, which color should it be? It could actually be red, so we can see. Or it could also be orange. And we can see which one has the focus right now. It's not actually not hover, it was focus that was. And then we choose the, we don't want any shadow on it, so let's just remove that, remove the shadow also from there. Because I copy pasted from the input, from the submit button. So here we have solids, and we do not, let me just choose another color right here. It goes from like bluish color, like this. And then it should actually go into the orange color like that. Let's try to see what happens. Okay, much cooler again actually. So now we have, you can see the small line under there, that is the border that we played around with. We press right here, then it turns orange, and we can actually see which field has the focus. Much, much cooler. I think the padding inside the input fields are a little bit too big, right? So let's choose 5 instead. See what happens. It's also the font size inside it. It's not the padding is almost okay. Let's say the font size. Is it 1 IM? This, oh no, okay. Padding was actually okay. Now actually it got very small, but I don't know actually if it's actually better now or not. Maybe a bit bigger. 1.5 IM. Okay, I think this is a sweet spot. Actually, we could also choose the focus right now, because I can actually tap to the submit button and then it gets the focus. So let us choose, just like it actually should change, just like if it was hovering. So let's see. Focus. Look, now it actually gets the same effect as if we were actually hovering over it with the mouse. Very, very cool. I actually like this. I like this form now. Now we can actually create a new spaceship. Spaceship 2. Spaceship 2. 20, 200, 1000. And then we get. At least it's much prettier than it was before we started the tutorial. I hope so. I hope you would agree with me. The yellow color, of course, it could also be changed to orange. We have a lot of orange colors right here. We could also use some variables. That's a you'll never get you'll never be done with styling. That's an ongoing process, right? So but let me find the yellow color. And let us try to change this to label to points. I think that's the last thing we do. The trick is not to use too many colors. It was not a good idea. Let us choose the yellow one again. The trick is not to use too many colors, then it starts looking weird. And so and the border here, maybe we should try with some more pixels. You can hear, it's difficult to stop actually, because it's actually a lot of fun to play around with styling. Let's try with 4 pixels solids instead. Oh, that is a text. Yes, that's fine. Border button. Okay, that's in focus. Let us just see. Press there. We get this fat one in the bottom. Yeah, maybe it's better. And we can also choose that instead of solid, then it could be dotted instead or something like that. Dotted. Dot dash. That's also a good one. I never used that actually. Dot dash. Let's try that. Then press here. Ah, okay, it does not. Dot dash. Try that. Looks kind of cool, doesn't it? It looks very, very cool. It should have the same size, I think. It gives another effect. Maybe the first effect, of course, was the most the cleanest one, of course. Dot dot dash. Let's try that. See what happens then. Dot dot dash. Okay, that was not available. Okay, let us keep it to solid for now, and then and maybe 3 pixels. Maybe that's a sweet. Let's press. Ah, it's so pretty. I'm so proud of myself as usual. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, I will commit all this code and I'll upload it as usual to GitHub. If you like this video, of course, I would appreciate if you also please press the like button. If you subscribe, then you will get more content from me in the future. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.